Okay, now factorization of trinomials. What is a trinomial? A trinomial is an expression that has three terms. So you will see here we have term one, term two, and the third term. So we refer to that as a trinomial. And if your trinomial has one of the terms being raised to the power of two, that means the highest degree is two, then we call it a quadratic. All right. So how do we go about factorizing this? So first try to notice in your standard form, starting with x squared, x and the c, it has to be in a standard form, which is ax squared plus bx plus c. All right. So factorizing this, you will have two brackets. All right. So you have to determine the signs. If your trinomial or your quadratic has a plus and the plus, so in the middle term and the last term, then both your brackets are going to be plus. Then you will be looking for terms of C such that if you add them, you get the middle term. You're going to look for the terms of C such that if, when you add them, you get the middle term B. All right. And then what if now your quadratic, the middle term is a positive and your last term is a negative? All right. We're going to still have two brackets. One bracket will be positive and the other bracket will be a negative. You are going to look for the terms of C such that if you subtract them, you get the middle term. Great. And then for a negative and a plus, your brackets will both have a negative. And then you're going to look for the terms of C such that if you add them, you get the middle term. And then lastly, if your middle term is a negative and the last term is a negative, then in one bracket, you're going to have a positive, and the other you will have a negative. You're also still going to find the terms of C such that when you subtract them, you get the middle term B. All right, let's go right ahead. So we have x squared plus x minus 42. So two brackets. So it's a plus and a negative. One bracket will be positive and the other bracket will be negative. The terms of x squared can only be x times x. Okay, if we separate this, how do we get an x? It's going to be x multiplied by x. So x multiplied by x gives us x squared. So this come here, x multiplied by x. And then for the factors of 42, we're going to look at the last term now, the factors of 42. If you go to your calculator, press number 42, press equal sign, then you're going to press shift, and then you're going to press the button fact. As soon as you press fact, you're going to get the prime factors of number 42, that it's 2 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 3. Sorry, 2 times 3 times 7. So we go and say, what is 42 divided by the number 2? It's 21. So that means your 21 multiplied by 2 will give you 42. And then we're using now the factor 3. What is 42 divided by 3? You'll get a 14. So this means that 3 times a 14 is a 42. And lastly, using the prime factor 7, what is 42 divided by 7? It will give you 6. This means that 7 times a 6 gives you a 42. So 3 factor pairs of 42. 2 times 21 is 42. 3 times 41 is 42. And 7 times a 6 is 42. But which pair will give us a 1? Look at our B here. Our B is a 1. Remember, if there's nothing here, there, the coefficient is a 1. Which factor pair will give us a 1 if we subtract them? Okay, let's check. 2 minus 21 will give us 19. Not a 1. 3 minus 14, it's going to give us 11. Not a 1. But 7 minus 6 will give us a 1. So that means that factor pair that we're going to make use of is a 7 and a 6. All right. But which one will be negative and which one will be positive? We're going to check the sign of our middle term is a positive. So the bigger number between 7 and 6 will be a positive and the other one will be a negative. So we're going to have x plus a 7 and x minus a 6. If you multiply this out, it should take you back to x squared plus x minus 42. So x times x is x squared. X times minus 6 is minus 6x. And 7 times x, it's going to be plus 7x. So this minus 6x plus 7x will give us 1x, that's in the middle there. And finally, 7 times minus 6 is minus 42. So that's how you go about just checking to make sure that your factorization is correct. So our factorization of x squared plus x minus 42 is x plus 7x minus 6. All right, how about this one? We have the factors of 2x squared. Let's have our brackets. The factors of 2x squared can only be 2x times x. Can't be anything else. When you say 2x multiplied by x, then you get your 2x squared. So we have negative, negative. Then we know that one bracket is going to be negative and the other will be positive. And then let's check the factors of 6. If you do the same thing, 6 equal sign shift fact, you will see that the factors of 6 is 2 multiplied by 3. Okay, since it's two terms, we don't need to be testing because we know that 6 divided by 2 will give us a 3 and 6 divided by 3 will be a 2. So there's no need of having different factor pairs like we have here. All right. So we're going to have 2 by 3. So let's check if we pair 2 by 2x of the others, what we get. So for 2x squared is 2x and an x. All right. If we have 2 times 2x, we get 4x. And if we have 3 times x, we get 3x. So remember, what's the rule? If we subtract them, we have to get a minus 1. All right. So let's see. 4x, if we say 4x minus 3x, we're going to get positive x. We are looking for minus x. So that means if If we say 4x minus, if it's a minus 3, then it gives us a positive x. But if that minus goes to the 4x, then we're going to have minus 4x plus 3x, then we get minus x. So the negative has to go with the 4. All right. So we see that 2x has to go with a 2. Okay. So 2x is on the outer, and the outer of the other bracket is over there. So that means the 2 of the 6 is going to be positioned here. And x has to go with a 3. So since it's in here, it's going to go to with the inner of the other bracket. So x goes with a 3. And then remember, whatever that will give us a 4x has to have a negative. So 2x times a 2, that will have a negative, and the other one will be a positive. All right. So if you multiply this out, it's going to be 2x squared minus 4x plus 3x will give us minus x, and 3 times minus 2 will be minus a 6. Okay. So the factorization of 2x squared minus x minus a 6 is 2x plus 3, x minus 2. All right. And then the last one is of factor 54. We're going to look for the factors of 54. Okay, let's get our brackets. Okay, so the factors of x squared can only be x and x. And then one bracket is going to be positive, and the other bracket is going to be negative. Okay, so for 54, the factors of 54 will be, all right, so we go to a calculator again, press 54, equal sign, shift, factorial, and then we get that the factors are 2. On the calculator, it will give you 2 times 3 cubed. Okay, if you go 54 equal sign shift fact, you're going to get 2 times 3 cubed. And we know that this 3 cubed is a 27. So that means the factors of 54 that we can make use of is 2 times 27. Okay, between 2 and 27, unfortunately, when you take 27 divided minus 2, you're not going to get a 15. So we have to get other factors. Okay, the other factors that were not part of the factorial there would be 18 and a 3. If you multiply number 3, if you multiply 3 by 18 on your calculator, you will see that you get number 54. 18 times 3 is 54, and then 18 minus 3 gives us a 15. So the factors that we are looking for is a 3 and an 18. So between 3 and an 18, which one will be positive, which one will be negative? We go look at the sign of the middle term. Since the middle term is positive, the bigger number will be positive, and that small one will then be negative. So that means we're going to have plus 18 minus a 3. All right. And then the other one, let's see, two brackets. So we can have the factors of 3x squared can only be 3x and x. We know with this one, both brackets are going to be positive. And the factors of 2 can only be 2 and 1. Only when you multiply 2 by 1 will you get a 2. But remember, when you add these things, you have to get the middle term 7. So obviously, 2 has to go with a 3 there to give us a 6. Since it's 3 is on the outer, its 2 would be on the outer as well. And then the 1 will come this side. So 6x plus 1x will give us 7x. All right, and how about this one? Okay, it's the scenario of a negative and a plus on our trinomial. So we're going to have two brackets. And we know that if we have a negative on the middle term and a positive as the last term, then both brackets are going to be negative. The terms of x squared can only be x and x. And that of 6 can either be 6 times 1, or it can be 2 times 3. Okay, so we know that if we add the terms, we should get a 7. Okay, let's see which one gives us a 7. But 2 plus 3 is a 5, not a 7. But 6 plus 1, that gives us a 7. So those are the terms we're going to make use of. And since both are negative, it doesn't matter where which one goes. So we can put 1 there and 6 there, or the other way around, 6 on the other side or 1 on the other side. So if we multiply this out, it's going to be x times x, which is equals to x squared. Then we're going to have x times minus 6, which is minus 6x. And then we will have minus 1 times x, which is minus x. Then we know that minus 6x minus x will give us minus 7x, which is our middle term over there. All right. And then minus 1 times minus 6 will be positive 6. So our factorization of x squared minus 7x plus 6 is x minus 1, x minus 6.